1. Chapter 1. A Lesson in Survival. Halloween 2017. Ace was in the back seat, recounting an episode of Wildcrats. At 4, my son lived for his cartoons, and he could reel off facts about all the animals he saw on the nature show. "Did you know there are fish that can fly?" he asked us. "Fish that fly?" I said. "Yeah, they're called flying fish." "Well, that's a good name for them," I said. Eric was at the wheel driving us to a Tuesday morning Halloween assembly at our daughter Maxwell's school. I sat on the passenger side, absently practicing my "I have it together" face. It was 7:30 in the morning and I had already had a drink. I always had a glitter cup in reach at home. That's what I called the shiny tumblers filled with vodka and flavored Perrier. At that time, the flavor was mostly strawberry, but by then I didn't care what it tasted like. I just needed a drink every morning because I had the shakes. My anxiety always kicked into high gear before school functions, and there had been a few performances since Maxwell started kindergarten in September. I knew how important they were, even if it made me nervous. All these 5-year-olds in their navy blue school uniforms learning not to be scared to perform in front of so many people. Maxwell was going to sing at the Halloween assembly, and I tried to get her to practice the song in front of me at home the night before. "I want to surprise you," she said. "No, but I really want to know what you're doing," I said. "I want to know if I can help out." "I got it," she said. "That is my daughter." Maxwell is so like my younger sister, Ashley, and I love them both for their independence. I constantly find myself calling Maxwell Ashley and vice versa. Maxie is in control, and I never want to be overbearing. It was hard for me not to try to protect her when she was too young to understand nerves yet. When she would say, "Why is my tummy upset?" before a performance, I'd feel a sympathetic flip of my own stomach, remembering all the times I had nerves before going on stage or doing an interview. Eric knew what that was like, too, that feeling right before you went on the field playing football, yell, or for the 49ers, that pressure of everyone looking at you. I felt it then in the car headed to school. By then, I had engineered my life so the world mostly came to my house, a comfortable hangout place for my family and friends. And I had the ability to do almost all the business side of my collection there, too. I even had my own recording studio. I could be safe at home. It was almost a shock that morning to realize, God, I have to put myself together? Put the pieces of the puzzle together from a memory of who people expected me to be. I knew I was falling apart, but I had to look like a good mom who was present for her children. Which I was. I am. But I was just never going to be the cupcake mom or the arts and crafts helper at school. Even then, when I knew I was operating at about 15%, I knew I was a good mom. We pulled into the lot and I spotted my dad's new Mercedes. It was hard to miss, a bright green custom sports car I recognized from his Instagram. I had not seen much of my father since my parents split in 2012. They were married for 34 years, and I had a hard time being around them together since they had stopped loving each other. My father decided to tell me his plan to leave my mother when I was at Cedars-Sinai Hospital a week before I delivered Maxwell. No spotlight is safe around a Simpson. We'll steal it every time. I was blindsided by this news, which triggered his natural salesmanship. He pitched it to me like it was a positive thing. "You gave me the confidence," my father added quietly. "You gave me a way out." "Great," I thought to myself. I broke my own heart. When he left the room, I broke down. I gave my father a way out of his marriage to my mother. I didn't want to be thanked. I wanted them to be grandparents. I wanted them to be there for me as I was about to have my first child. Eric had to hold me as I repeated over and over, "It's not my fault." 5 years later, my dad was inside waiting for us in the gymnasium at Maxwell's school.